Good morning, my young friends. I hope you have had a wonderful week. I hope you enjoy being back in school, as some of you are, and I hope that you are excited to be here this morning. We love to come together and sing and play games and have fun, but most of all, we love to learn about Jesus and worship Him, don't we? Well, we're going to start this morning with some singing, and then after the singing, you're going to hear an interesting and exciting story from God's Word that helps us know better how to trust Him. So get ready, stand up, get loose, put your smile on, and let's worship Jesus.
Just follow me through.
Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Oz got a Bible story for me and you.
That should do it. Oh, hola, friends. I'm Luis the Handyman. I just finished fixing this gavel for my friend. She's a judge and uses this in her courtroom. She knocks it on her desk when she wants to say something. Or tell people what they should do. Speaking of judges, that reminds me of today's story. Do you want to help me build it? Great! Let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer! Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down now. Now, we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible begins with a woman named Deborah. Deborah was the leader of all God's people. She was their judge. Every day, Deborah would stand under a tree and the people would come to her with their big questions and ask her what to do. Deborah knew God was with her. She trusted God to help her be wise and tell the people the right thing to do. Now, God is always with you too. He can help you be wise and do the right thing. Like when, you and your friend both want to play with the same toy. You can be wise and remember that God wants us to love others by sharing. Or when your brother knocks over your blocks. Well, you can be wise and use kind words instead of yelling at him. Or when you see someone get hurt, you can be wise and remember that God wants us to help people. God was with Deborah and helped her be wise. God is always with you and can help you be wise and do the right thing, too. Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who is always with you?
God is always with me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who is always with you?
God is always with me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Adios.
Good job, boys and girls. I love your singing. And who was our story about today? Do you remember? Her name was Deborah. We don't hear about Deborah a whole lot, but we learned in our story that she was a very special person. What did Deborah do? That's right. She was the judge. She helped people decide who was right and who was wrong and what was good decisions. God gave Deborah wisdom, his wisdom, so that she could be very wise and make good decisions. That's wonderful. It's a wonderful thing. And you know what, boys and girls? God promises to be with you and me too, to help us make wise decisions, good decisions. But sometimes it's hard for us to make on our own. But God provides wisdom for us when he walks with us, and he's willing to do that all the time if we will let him. So they told us in our story some examples of what might be a wise decision and maybe not a wise decision. Now, I thought maybe we could just think of a few more. Can you maybe think of one? Yeah. Maybe your mom has said, okay, it's time for bed now, and you really don't want to go. Really don't want to, and we know that it's always good to obey our parents, we know that. But we also know that there might be a reason why going to bed is a wise decision besides obeying your mom or dad. It's a wise decision because if you don't get enough sleep, you know you're going to be really tired and really grouchy in the morning, right? So it's wise to get some sleep. And your mom has a lot of wisdom from God that maybe you don't have yet, and that's why it's good to listen to her. Because she is our mom, she loves us, and she makes good decisions for us. What about if you have a friend maybe that says, let's go out and play in the street for a while. That would be really fun. It's kind of soft on this grass and it'd be fun. We could run faster in the street. Let's play out there. Would that be a wise decision to make? Probably not, huh? Probably not. And if you ask God, should we go play in the street? Does that help me to make a good decision? God would probably help you be wise and say to your friend, no, I'm going to stay in the yard. I think it's safer in the yard and I'm going to stay here and make a wise decision. There are so many things that God can help us choose wisely if we ask him to. So boys and girls, would you remember to ask Jesus to help you make wise decisions? And you know what's really awesome about that? Sometimes we could ask our mom or dad, but maybe mom went to get groceries and she's not here right now. Or maybe dad's at work and I can't have a chance to talk to him, but God is always with you. Always. You just have to let him stay with you and talk with you. And you have to listen. But God doesn't ever leave you. He's never away. He's never busy. He's never sleeping. He's never too tired to talk to you. God is always with you. That's what the Bible tells us. And God was always with Deborah to help her make wise decisions. And he will be with you to help you. if you let him. That's the wonderful, one of the wonderful gifts that God gives us, is that he promises to be near to us all the time. And we're going to pray right now and thank God for that. So I just want you to get ready. You know what you need to do to get ready so that your eyes don't distract you and your hands don't distract you. You do whatever you need to do. And then we're going to pray and thank God that he stays close to us and will help us when we need him. Ready? God, we are so thankful that you love us with all your heart and that you promise to always be with us, even when we're not aware that you're there, even when we don't feel you or see you there. You are with us and will help us. You'll help us to do what's right. You'll also help us to do what's wise. And we just thank you for that. And we desire that we would more and more depend on you being with us. In your name, amen. Good job, boys and girls. Well, it's been a great day to be with you. I hope you have a wonderful week. Please remember that God promises to be with you, and he'll help you to make wise decisions if you let him. I love you. Bye-bye. Have a good week.